Hi, my name is Anne. I'm one of the academic technologists in CLA, and I want to show you the three places that instructors can leave feedback for students and the three places that you as a student can look for them so that you can get all of that rich feedback that your instructor intended for you to have. I am in Firefox as a test student. The test student's name is Michael Scott, and he has uploaded a PDF of his assignment to this assignment, Should the Web Be Anonymous? And I'm going to take you over to the instructor view so you can see the three places that your instructor may have placed feedback and where you can look for it. Here is Michael Scott's assignment in the Speedgrader, which is the interface that your instructor uses to grade your assignment. Your instructor may use the annotation tools in the Speedgrader. They may highlight something and add a comment. They also might use some of these other tools like the text tool or the strikethrough tool and adding more comments. So that is one of the places that you might look for feedback. And again, I'm going to show you where to look for this as a student in a moment. Another place that your instructor might leave you feedback is in the rubric itself, if your instructor uses a rubric. So I am pulling out the rubric. Your instructor can add a comment based on individual criteria in the rubric itself. One of the criteria here is assessing the ideas that were presented in this essay. So your instructor might click on that comments icon, and they may also comment on any of the other criteria as well. That's the second place they might leave you feedback. The third place is in the general comments area. So what does this look like for you on your side of things, students? Let's go over and take a look. Michael Scott, our test student, will see the generic rubric that was used for the assignment when he clicks into the assignment view. He needs to click on View Rubric Evaluation, which is a link on the far right side of the screen, in order to see those individual comments. And they're not necessarily very obvious, which is why we're making this video for you. So you have to have clicked into that View Rubric in order to see the instructor comments. And you can see my comments in Ideas and under the Criterion Organization. Recall that this instructor also added some comments using the annotation tools. So how can you see those annotations? You have to again go back into the assignment itself and click either Submission Details or View Rubric Evaluation, as we did a moment ago, and then click onto the View Feedback icon. And you'll probably want to launch that into full screen so that you can see the comments there. And I pressed my Escape button on my keyboard in order to get out of that view. There are two more places that you can look for this feedback. One of them is on the main page itself. You can view a truncated version of just the general comments that your instructor made using the assignment comments area. I am clicking back to the home page of this course and scrolling down, and here on the main page I can see just those comments. The last place that you can look for comments is in grades. So click on grades and let's scroll down to this assignment. Here's the assignment we've been looking at this whole time. You've got two icons letting you know that there is both comments in the rubric and comments in the assignment itself. Click that comments icon to reveal the comments there. Click the rubric to go to the rubric and again find these instructor comments. And notice that in all cases, in order to see annotations that have been left directly on your assignment, you need to go back to the assignment itself. I hope this short tutorial has been useful, and hope you have a great semester.